Morning, folks. Right, it was far too dark to film under the tree canopy, so I've replaced the rear axle on the Austar. I'm going to have to stick to the past until I can get some more open trees, if you know what I mean. I'm afraid there's not going to be much of a video today. It's just been back at 5 o'clock in the morning and there's not a lot of light yet. Unlike yesterday where it was nice and sunny, it's quite dull and overcast today, so as soon as you go under as you go into bushes or undergrowth, as you can see, the truck basically disappears. So it's just going to have to be a bit of a hiking video this morning. As you can see that I've used some of the Trans Am letters, stuck them in the roof. To break up that mass expanse of red, you know. Is this going to be an open path, I wonder? It might not be a path at all. No, it's just where they chopped the tree down. I was hoping it might have been a firebreak path. I can't get up that. Oh, no problem at all. Very good. For those of you that have asked, why is there no undergrowth under the trees? This is very much a cared for park. Now, any diseased trees or there's another part of the park that you don't see, or that you haven't seen yet. I need to stick, as I say, I need to stick to the paths because it's just too dark under the trees at the moment. Drainage ditch does not look very good. Don't know if we're down that. This is a huge park. It's not small by any stretch of imagination. It covers a total of 324 acres. So go walking for hours in here. yes, there is a pond here. Get where I want to go this morning. Ooh, hang on. Path along the pond side. Let's get a bit more fouled up over the decades. Selling this today. I haven't recharged my fees. I mean, even two SS's. It's quite a nippy little thing. Well, just to stock 35 ton motor that's in it. Coming this way brings us round to the earthworks in an entirely different direction. Remember years ago we used to go fishing for perch in here. Bearings right. And, it should be here. Mm. too far up. Right station that I am. As you see under the canopy, it's a bit dull. The sun's only just now starting to break through the canopy in places. Hopefully this is going to come out not too bad. Well, it depends on how dense the trees are, you know. The denser the trees, the less light. Yes, I'm afraid the drawback of filming at this time in the morning. This is very dark this morning. This may well be unwatchable. It's amazing the difference half an hour makes. You know? If this had been 5:30, rather than 4:15, it made a big difference as far as light levels went. I do not have a light bar on this, so cut down the amount of light available for filming. I know you like my early morning runs, but today's is just very poor. Far too dark this morning. Pretty branch sitting on those ruts. The sun's starting to leave streaks. can see the early streaks of sunlight breaking through the trees. There's a truck to show up quite a bit better. There's enough light to get film on the way back. See a number of people I see turning around and saying, well, you know, the truck's crap, you've blown an axle. Yeah, the truck's a year old, you know. Only effectively losing the diff in an axle after a year's worth of running over all sorts of terrain, through mud, water, streams, over rocks. You know, wind there. I like this little truck. And even fully loaded as it is. So the design made it. It only weighs 6 pounds. Well, it's a lightweight rig. Not that light, but a light enough one. Nice by a puddle. Problem is there enough light to film it? I'm still running the original servo that I bought for this, which was one of the cheap £5 Power Pro servos. Not waterproof, so I stripped it apart and conformal coated it and took conformal coating around all the joints. No, I'm not going to jump it. I've just been putting the shell together. All that remains of what used to be my test tree. I'm sorry, I'm not quite up to my usual luck in filming these videos, but you can't always dictate lighting conditions. This is more like a nighttime run than anything else. Although I could, I'm not going to put the light bar on this. I'm going to keep it as a nice little plain body Jeep. clicked it completely wrong, right? And didn't hit that at all well. Oh dear. I hit that one even worse. Oh, it's nice and bright here. Yeah. You see the difference straight away between being underneath the canopy and being where the canopy is less dense. Giving me a decent length walk today. Log pile looks good, but there's no way I can climb over it, unfortunately. Couldn't see from that angle what that stump was like. Let's see if I can get up from here. Hey. Head back down towards the car. You see, straight away we're looking at some light levels. As soon as we come under here, it starts to darken down. Reasonably good as the camera may be, it does not like the light levels. As we were around this bend, it will almost disappear, I think. Well, unfortunately, we can't always get decent videos. Today was just more like an exercise trail than anything else. window of my tires. Sorry, it wasn't such a good video today. Whims the brakes, I'm afraid. Right, well, that's all for today, folks. Hopefully you can actually see something in the video. But please take care out there, and I will catch you on the next one. Bye for now.